Didn't matter. Winter, spring, summer, fall, rain, snowstorm, lightning storm, it didn't matter. He was going to be there no matter what, opening up that gym. What did he show me? He showed me the kind of dedication that it took. Hi, this is John. Thank you for stopping by once again to Mr. America Heart. Today I'm going to share with you three hot tips that were given to me from three great bodybuilders, each one great in their own right. And first, I'm going to share with you a few of the common themes between the three of them. Number one is each one of them was an IFBB professional bodybuilder. Two is each one of them had won at least the Mr. America contest and at least their class in the Mr. America contest. And each one of them shared with me either by telling me to my face or showing me these three tips. So the first one I want to talk to you about is Jim Morris. Jim Morris not only won his class in the Mr. America in the early 70s, he also won the overall title and went on to become a successful Masters pro in the IFBB and the Olympia, the Mr. Olympia contest. And he was a personal friend of mine. Jim also happened to be a judge at my very first novice contest that I won. And afterwards, I went to Jim and I asked him, you know, if he can give me any advice. As a new bodybuilder, competitive bodybuilder, I was interested in what he had to say. And this is back in the day when, you know, judges actually gave real advice, okay? And Jim said to me, look, be honest with yourself, he said. Be honest with yourself. If you are a greyhound, then be the best greyhound you could be. A greyhound does not necessarily try to be a bulldog. If you're a bulldog, be the best bulldog you can be. And in further talking with him, what was he talking about with me? What did he mean by this? The first thing was to be honest with yourself. So he was telling me to be honest with myself about the type of physique I had and also how far I could go with it. So Jim was saying to me in the middle of our conversation to not be like him, meaning as he got older, he was a bodybuilder and he was still training people in his 70s, in his early 70s at that point. So, you know, actually he was in his late 60s at that point. He was still training people and he was going right up until the day that he passed, he was still training people to the very end. He didn't have much. So he was telling me to get in and then get out. Be the best you can be, go as far as you can, because we all know that really, a greyhound type of physique does not go super far in bodybuilding. So I was of the lighter bone structure. I was not a behemoth. I was not a hulking physique. So he was telling me to be honest with myself, and that's exactly what I did. And eventually, I competed till I got the titles that I wanted to have, and then I got out of competition. And that's when I moved on to other things, such as this YouTube channel. So this is kind of fun to do. And it extends your career into other areas or other arenas, and you're not reliant entirely upon training people. So it was an honest moment he was having with me, and that I really appreciated. So being honest with yourself. So second person, Eddie Giuliani. Eddie Giuliani won his class, the short class, in the Mr. America contest, also in the mid-70s. And Eddie was the manager. He was a general manager of World Gym in Venice, and then eventually World Gym when it was in Marina Del Rey. Now, Eddie's a great guy. For those of you that don't know him, he's a jokester. He's funny. For him to even have a moment, I mean a moment of, you know, giving out serious advice was, you know, a moment I would listen to. So Eddie is, he's not gone anywhere. Eddie's still here today. Eddie's a great friend, a great guy. And the thing that Eddie shared with me, we were talking about getting in shape and what it takes to get in shape. And he said to me, well, you got to get out of shape. Now, stunning, right? Stunning. What do you mean get out of shape? And he says to me, you got to get out of shape before you can get in shape. Wow. This was a revelation. I mean, I never heard anybody say this to me before. So I took it seriously. And when he explained it to me further, he said, you have to have an off season. You can't always maintain exactly the same kind of conditioning all the time. You'll burn out. you have to back off a little bit. So you gain a little bit of weight, you lose a little bit of weight throughout the year. And when you do that, it's easier, it's more motivating, your body responds better during those times where you want to get in peak condition, as opposed to struggling all the time to remain super lean or staying all the time in contest condition. So this was something that I understood and I really appreciated it. And it's tip number two right here. You got to get out of shape to get in shape. How much out of shape? Now you guys know, if you've read any of my books or anything that I've ever written, Physique 101 is a book that I've written, a little shameless plug right there. You can go to my website, MrAmericaHeart.com, and check out that book. It's in a simple download. But I talk about in there the type of cycles that I would do throughout the year and the kind that I teach to people where you don't get really way out of shape, but you do back off. And then turn it up a little bit for an event, or you turn it up a little bit for the summer, or you turn it up a little bit just because you really want to be in good shape. So if you practice cycles like that, you'll find it's much easier to get in shape and then also to maintain it for quite a while. So that was tip number two. The third one, Steve Mihalik. Steve Mihalik also won the Mr. America contest, not just his class, but the overall back in the early 70s, very early 70s. And then he went on to be an IFBB pro, a successful IFBB pro. And he owned one of the very first gyms I ever belonged to, Mr. America's Body Shop in Farmingdale, Long Island. And Steve was a different kind of character. He was, you hear stories about him, let's just put it that way. And as a young man, as a teenager, I was in that gym doing my business, training hard. And, you know, I was fortunate enough to go to breakfast quite a few times with him. And he would share with me not only tips on training, but also some examples of the things that he went through as a bodybuilder just to get to be the best that he could be. And I know you all have heard some really hardcore stories about him, but sometimes you got to get a little bit crazy if you want to be the best at what you're doing. And so the one big tip that I got from him is not one that he actually said to me. It was one that he showed to me. He showed it to me every winter that I worked out there. You see, when we would have snowstorms in New York, the snow was not just a little light feather dusting of snow. It was deep. We had some serious snowfall. And when we would, man, it was dangerous driving on those icy roads and those snow-packed roads. Steve was always at the gym, opening up the gym on time. That key was going to be in that lock, opened up, didn't matter. Winter, spring, summer, fall, rain, snowstorm, lightning storm, it didn't matter. He was going to be there no matter what, opening up that gym. What did he show me? He showed me the kind of dedication that it took to excel at what he was doing. He wanted to be the best bodybuilder that he could be, best in the world. He said it many times. And he was great. Mr. America, Mr. Universe, successful IFBB pro. However, the real lesson that I got from him was watching him show up at that gym. I knew he'd always be there at opening time, training himself, or he'd have the door unlocked for those who wanted to train, because he knew it was important to the rest of us. So any of us who showed up, even as a teenager, I showed up at that gym. I mean, he was patting me on the back for showing up at that gym, showing up, training, even in crappy weather, even in snowstorm. A snowstorm was so deep that you could hardly walk through it. He walked to the gym several miles from his house. He walked to the gym. One day I vividly recall, he just bypassed the car because the roads were bad. He walked to the gym just to unlock that door so that he could train, so that people like myself could train, who wanted to train and who could get there no matter what. So he taught me you got to get a little bit crazy if you want to achieve the things you want to achieve, if you want to get to be the best that you could be in whatever you're doing. And so this lesson I observed with him. So to reiterate really quick, Jim Morris, it was be honest with yourself, be honest with the kind of physique that you have. Eddie Giuliani, it was you got to get out of shape to get in shape. And then Steve Mihalik, by example, he led by example. Do whatever it takes to achieve your goal. Get to the gym.
Thank you for watching. Please hit the subscribe button below before you leave.